Hello again, this is Kent, and we are again in the Inkscape Tutorials for Beginners series, creating shapes, and this is part two, or part B, of creating shapes. The first part is where we were creating rectangles, and then this one will be circles. Now, the other shapes, we probably will not get into them, because I don't... Well, if you want to find out about them, try to find another video, because... I don't deal with them that much. So when you're wanting to create a circle or ellipse, click on this tool, or you can hit F5. You can hold the control key down to make a circle. Now if you kind of pull your mouse over to the right, it'll pop into an ellipse. I still have my control key down on my keyboard. Now this is an ellipse. It's a 1-to-2 ellipse. And then you can pull even further to make it a 3. Let's see. I think that's a 3-to-1, if it's not 4-to-1. But anyway, you get the idea. You can start out with a perfect circle and then move your mouse over to the right. You're still holding down your left button on your mouse, and that's a 2-to-1, and then you go with maybe that's a 3-to-1, and then you go with a 4-to-1. Anyway, that's gives you a definite size ellipse that you might be interested in doing. Maybe I should make this a little bigger. Now I can hold control key down and make it keep it a circle. Or I can let go. I'll make it a circle. And I'll bring it back down here. Now I double click this to bring back the handles. Oops. There. And it looks like I grabbed one of those handles at one point. If you ever want to make it into a circle, go up to here and close and hit this button. I'll go back here, and you see it can make like almost like a piece of pie or a Pac-Man figure. And that's if you have your, see the cursor is on the outside. If you go to the inside, then it's like a section of a circle or something. There's a half circle, semicircle. And this is an unclosed shape, I guess. Now that's closed. And you can play around with it. Okay, I don't have much to this video because there's not really as much to do with circles, I guess. But let me just go in briefly with this 3D thing, and I can try to use my history in drawing. And that's too okay. Now, all I did was just drag and let go eventually after drawing my 3D box. This is basically a 2D perspective, I guess. I mean, you have vanishing points here at this end on the left and vanishing point on here on the right. The vertical lines are basically, they're parallel and they go straight up, it looks like. But you can actually change this perspective and then with all these different handles. So I guess if you really wanted to, you make a little city or something. Various buildings. Just play around with it and you'll probably get to understand this more than I do. And I'm sure you can change the colors. But I don't know exactly how to change, because you want to have one color being a little lighter than the other. Let's just go ahead and stop doing that one. And then let's go with the stars and the polygons. Right now it's on the star tool. And you see that you can change the amount of corners you have. And then you can change the spoke ratio. Now, the spoke ratio is, this is a ratio. It's the ratio, I think, of the dimension from this point to the center over this point to the center. Yeah. So as you increase it, it starts to become more like a polygon. And then if you decrease it, it starts to be a crazy looking star. Oh, and then if you go over to the rounded, it just rounds the tips. And if you go too far, it can make it look quite a bit different. So I can almost make this look like a gear or something if I wanted to. And then you can have randomized. So it's a randomized, looks like radii dimension, I don't know. Okay, that's enough of that. And then the spiral, you just play around with it because it's, I don't know, I'll be interested if people can find reasons to use it. I don't know what to use it for. Okay, that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked this video, and subscribe if you want to see more. Bye-bye.